We'll be going in a moment. They open at 10 a.m. So just shutting down the car and heading on in momentarily. Give me a moment to switch the camera too. This is the place. Exactly 10 o'clock. Hey, how's it going? Been a while. So this is the place where you can get a lot of things that you wouldn't normally be able to find. Look, a physics experiment. Well, looks like they still have the hyperbaric chamber. Elite stage capitalist toy. How nice. Well, this comes back down into which section we're in. Right now, we're in more of the general goods section, and we're moving in towards the industrial and electronic and mechanical section, but and then we get into the fabric and webbing side of things. I could probably use a roll of craft paper. That is a lot of tubing, but I don't know if it's... Is it shrink tubing? No, it feels like silicone. Interesting. Speaking of silicone, only this is silicon dioxide. Lots and lots of glass tube if you want to. Oh, sorry, no. These are plastic tubes. The glass tubes are elsewhere. Moving on down the aisle here, we get into the chemistry glassware. And perfume bottles and all of this stuff. I might need a kidney-shaped pan to throw up in. Black tie event funnels. Very nice. Yes, I'm happy with chaos as well, apparently. Alright, so if we go down here, we see more of the usual surplus wear, but quickly that's replaced with way more stuff that is a little bit less normal. They used to have enough marbles here that you could stick your hand in one of the things and just felt kind of weird. Anybody need some masking tape? Or any? any kind of tape. The Green-Eyed Devil Edition for painter's tape. Ooh, gaffer's tape. And more tape, and more tape, and more tape. Jesus, Sonny Jiggler. Good grief. Alright, so let's get into the electronics and industrial side. So we begin with the foams. And mice, and a whole bunch of other stuff, including lights, headlights, heat lamps. Heat lamps. Might want to grab a couple of these at some point for my chickens. We're in the lighting and cables section now. So, everything from spiral wrap to USB cords. And then, all of the various different LEDs and indicator lights over here. Now, oh yes, and also solar illuminated digits. What do we got here? On-off switches with nothing to on-off switch them with, or pair them to. A lot of antennas. If you need anti-static boxes, you got them here, along with many, many, many tubes. Please put them back nicely, or things will get weird real fast. Okay, I trust them. Well, I'm glad this isn't bad light duty wire. Life sure can be rough, as can be these little belts for belt grinders. Need a screw, need a bolt, need a nut. There's a small chance you might find one that fits your spec. Pluggers for your ear holes. There you go. Because that's what we need for clevises. More of these scales. And CCTV warning signs. Oh, nice. Fly rod cases. Or tubes, I guess I should say. Oh, this is new. Yes, flowers have teeth. And a lot of hose. Hoses. Let's see what the ninja stars actually are. Those don't look sharp enough. Alright. And now we're in valve land. Oh, valve and filter land, looks like. Pneumatics and hydraulics stuff here. Multiport valves. All digital, all the time. And if you need a meter, well, counters from Univac, back when Univac was here. glows, it glows. Wonderful. So now we're in Switchland. PSI 120 volt switches. Interesting. Then more switches and such behind me, along with then move into relays and contactors over here. I don't think I've ever seen a relay that was chromed on the outside. Don't think that's an RF thing because it's transparent on the top. I think it's just an aesthetic thing. Further switches. Now that is a limit switch. A micro switch indeed. Oh, hello. Go switches. The thing that never seems to stay in stock here very long is emergency stop buttons and switches. And those are the opposite of that. Various toggles and buttons and such. And we're getting into more limit switches and micro switches. And this bunch of stuff behind me really blows because it's a bunch of fans. Haha. Well, I mean, after all, fans both suck and blow simultaneously, so let's not be exclusionary. Ones with and without heat sinks. And then, well, do you need a bubbler for your water fountain? These are fun. Big old linear actuators down here. Some of these will easily handle like 100 pounds or more. Yes, I've played with some of those a few times and gotten a few in the past. Detectors? Question mark. Looks like PIRs to be precise. And then we've got a magnetron over here. Looks like it's out of an old Toshiba microwave. That? Some sort of Rockwell insulated enclosure. Looks like it's probably for some sort of lamp. Ooh. Electrophoresis gel caddies. Those are fun. Although their power supplies are more fun for me because I don't generally do much with gels. Oh, honey. Well, indeed. Deviation meters. Speakers, buzzers, etc. Yes, we've made it into the noisemaker section here. And over here, we wind up with pumps and all sorts of motors moving back up towards the fans. This is an interesting reciprocating arm device. Oh! Globe Vision Optics, that kind of gives it away. This is almost certainly a lens polisher. That being said, at $50... I have an idea for that. Here are the big boy contactors and relays. Now we're in the resistive elements. Vive la résistance. Vive le potentiometer. I guess. And this is interesting. This is a high power pot, it looks like. All that heat sinking for power dissipation is heat. Now we're over to thermal switches, inductors, things of that nature. And we have more resistors and capacitors over on this side. Oh, these are fun. These are old cam pieces for mechanical switch programming. You basically put these onto a shaft, it would then engage with a micro switch, and that shaft would turn at a given rate. So that would allow you to actually have control over a repeating process based on the alignment of this on the shaft. Oh, these are a personal favorite of mine. These pass-throughs and glands. Now, they may call them shinies, but really these are timing belt pulleys. Free weights for rats. Now we're into the bearing section. It has a lot of bearing on whether or not you can get something to rotate. I know, that was terrible. That's my job, isn't it? To be terrible like that. Bad puns and all. And so here we have everything from 0603 caps up to, well, those. It's a bit of a difference between one and the other. Alright, we're back to the hardware aisle again, as it were. And over here we've got some enclosures. Ooh. I think I spy some mil-spec connectors over here. Tape lie selector. No, tape lift selector. There we go. And speaking of enclosures, got more than a few over here as well. The thingus, which would probably be an antenna mount, actually. For a mast. I didn't mention these before, but these are all horizontal Lazy Susan style bearings. So those are only for vertical loading. As we make our way down here, we'll head on into the rest of Motorland. All sorts of fun gear here. Pun obviously intended, since there are gear motors. Over across from it, let's just say that things get a little bit standoffish. And then strain reliefs for any cable that you need to pass through a box. All the nylon hardware for, looks like, all the way up to quarter 20, which is kind of rare. 440 is usually what I see. Squish, it says. And the other side, 2 VU meter. Oh, this is fun. Somebody made a, so that's squish, and this one's zap. Looks like somebody made a couple of Oshpark PCBs, and somehow they wound up here. Huh. I know who made these. My former grad student in Fruita. I'm gonna buy these. His power supply is apparently bipolar. That's good to know. Looks like we got power conditioners over here. And then more motors. Especially low RPM gear motors, there's a lot of those here. Then, as we move further down here, the power supplies kind of spill over onto the other aisle. Oh no, she's having an easier time charging her electronic devices, thanks to this power adapter. Well, of course. with 100 to 240, it could be used anywhere. Anybody need some alligator clip leads? Tiny shrimp tube. Fun. Oh dear. Alright. So let's see about this last aisle over here. Alright, so here we've got the semiconductor side of things. Ooh. That's nice. Proximity switch. Alright, so over here, yeah, Zener diodes, transistors, all of that fun stuff. And then connectors. BNC, F, various 2-pin, 3-pin, etc. And chips, corn, potato, and robot flavored. So some of the semiconductor devices, especially the ICs, we've still got tubes of them down here, which is fun and interesting to see what exactly they've got in there. And then we got this big old periscope from a leopard tank. Some, those look to be 2-inch PVC ball valves here. Yeah, it starts getting weird from here, as usual. And then this is actually part of what I'm here for, is a couple of casters, but I'll grab those after the live stream. We've got posts for attaching them and locking and unlocking casters. Oh, these are wheelchair brake handles. Should ask my dad if he needs them for a couple of those, or actually just get them. And replacement wheelchair wheels, too. Not certain what that thing from 3M is, but I do know I used to have a pair of those welding goggles. From here, actually. 10 American cents. Alright, well, let's take a look further down over here. Because after the connectors, well, which, by the way, before the connectors, all the springs and miters for sock puppets. Fun! Alright. So, yeah, we go from low voltage to high voltage over here. And we've got everything from individual header rows to all these various other, like, Amphenol and Molex style connectors. Multipole, and then we've got a lot of BNCs. D-subs are down here as well as D-sub gender benders, modem terminals, terminators, and then more old-school connectors over here. Somewhere in amongst all of this, there's also a stash of ZIF sockets, which are really nice to have when you're doing programming of chips, and like this one right here, it's a nice little ZIF. So ZIF is zero insertion force. You, one moment please. You basically put the chip to be programmed in here, flip the lid down, and then that's held in place. And then you just push up and take the chip back out. So that's a ZIF. There are other designs that involve like having a lever on the side, and that's why I'm actually kind of looking forward to demonstrate the concept, but not seeing any of them right here right now. Board edge connectors as well. Some old school big mil-spec connectors for high amperage. can tell your amperage by the diameter of the conductors in the connector. And those are high amperage because they're thick, with about 5 to 10 C's on the end of thick. And spade connectors galore. And then we've got all this wire and tubing and shrink tube as well. Oh, this is interesting. This looks like... Well, this is interesting indeed. This is like 30 gauge wire in a cable. So, looks like it's four conductor. It'd be useful for some applications where you need something on the end of a wire to move and you send back a small signal. Since it's four conductors, I need to keep that in mind because I2C, one of the protocols I most often use, uses only four wires. And so I could put an accelerometer or IMU on the end of that and have it move and get the signal back along the cable. Then we come into plastics. And more cables. And 25% per foot tubing, which has a red line on it, but doesn't tell us what the diameter is. And now you know why this made it here to Axeman. Smiling makes it feel better. More plastic, and then shrink tube. And various colored zip ties. This is one of the few places locally you can find different colored zip ties in packages of just that color. And then more and more terminal blocks. And eventually we get over to some of the DIN rail stuff as well. And tube/relay sockets. That looks like an inline filter over there. And then these. Whew, these are just straight up bus bars. Also, I didn't mention this before, but on this side of things, on the semiconductor side, this is actually a rectifier diode. One of the biggest you'll probably ever see, but International Rectifier, part number 150, looks like KK20A, and I'm guessing the 20A is 20 amps, so this sucker can take a little bit of current. Alright. Let's see if we can take a look at the instrumentation rows, and then we'll shut down the stream for the moment. But first, Gewandenest. I wonder what that means. Seems German. All right. Just look at them. Like small stands for like a table or something. Is that a Pelican case for $30? Yep, genuine Pelican case. Bird Ale. If you wanted some real payoff, here's a bunch of old oscilloscopes. Even an optical TDR meter. And a Newton's cradle made out of bowling balls, just for good measure. Some of the stuff sometimes, like this Zeo multiplexer over here, actually comes with a manual. Over here we have thermal stuff. So these are thermocouple multiplexer boards, a black box ABC switch that only has A and B. Like we have a large auto transformer over here, a Loran unit for back when Loran was a thing. Ooh, what do we got here? It says BK Precision on the back. I'm automatically interested. Bars. And what have we here? looks like some sort of laminator. A very small record player too. Then behind me, a lot of projectors.
Those would be down aisle 8 on your right-hand side.
Along with video recorders and the like.
It's always worth a try, right?
For sure.
Don't forget to be easy on cheesy. That is the largest bobblehead Jesus I know of in the area. Screw terminal boards. Oh, just started snowing.
Oh, jeez.
Another analog storage oscilloscope. Hey Nick, long time no see. Nice little miter box. A Philco radio here. Looks like this one's a theater style old school projector, complete with, I'm guessing, sound output as well. Then behind me, a bunch of what look like probably inverter housings. We got some sort of auto transformer over here. Yeah, essentially a Variac in here, which is on. Oh, okay, so this is a lighting setup. Resistance bridge. And this looks to be some sort of oscillator. Don't know if this is the CW off tone and limiter. So this could either be a regenerative receiver for radio, or this could just be a tone generator. I think it's probably the former rather than the latter. And then this, now that is a power supply. So, good grief. That is quite the, quite the centrifuge too. Regulated power supply. This is a Lambda. Ah, from back when Univac turned into Sperry Univac. All these balls. Dual reel-to-reel recorders. Very nice, very nice. Alright, some more boards and such. Back where we started in this area. And I think that's pretty much going to be it. We've gone through most of Axeman Surplus here in St. Paul, Minnesota, and hope you enjoyed the tour. If you're ever in the area, it is definitely the place to get the thing that you need, whatever it may be. See you later.